Welcome back to Let's Play Song of the Ocean Blind. I'm Amethyst Notari. We all have the sheet metal now. Sheet metal. Sheet armor? Except for Ada. Yeah, sheet armor. But Ada's like the stand-in, like the tag town, the tag team thing. So I don't use her that often. If we do, I'm not gonna actively grind to get her the sheet armor, but if we end up with 2,800 gents and we can buy it, we end up back here or whatever, I'll buy her one. We're about to level up, so let's fight these things again. To go towards Ada's cause anyway. When we surprise the enemy, it's great. You know, I'm tired of McBain not being able to attack on his first round, so let's have him attack this one so he can reach, and the rest of us will attack this one. Because otherwise we knock it out of his way. He can't punch. I don't know if Forte can even reach. No! Oh, that was a bad... All I did was trade one. Forte couldn't move instead. Alright, let's finish this one off. Gonna level up, some of us. A couple of us. McBain, level 30. McBain has learned a Gaia Crush. Una has learned Spread Arrow. And Forte has learned Loud Rush. Oh, and Jan and Rick. Didn't learn anything. And Ada hasn't leveled up yet. So, let's see. Loud Rush. Okay, it's a finishing move. Upgrade for his Jump Rush, I guess. Jump Rush is a sword technique to lash the enemy while jumping. And Loud Rush is a sword technique that is an improved and reinforced version of Jump Rush. Sounds good. I look forward to checking it out. And McBain, yeah, I don't know what this thing next to it means. See, next to the R of Rock Crash, this is like a symbol. Okay, so Rock Crash, we know that's a punch technique that destroys even rocks. And this is a punch technique that destroys even the earth. My god. And then Una has learned Spread Arrow. An arrow technique to launch multiple shining arrows, as opposed to this, pierce through the enemy with a shining arrow. So, good to know. Now we can fight this, and I think Ada will level up then. And then we'll be on our way. I love surprising the enemy. I love the smell of surprised enemies in the morning. Nice! The rails took that out. So maybe McBain can reach this one. No, he's still gonna reach. We need to get you, like, I don't know, long pole arms so you can reach your enemy. And you can put your little boxing glove on the end of the pole arm and there you go. Sweet. Negative. Oh, I forgot to switch it. Wait, do I choose? I choose the finishing move, don't I? I didn't level up yet. Next time, probably. So how do I do it? How do I... Because I didn't see anything to choose and I completely forgot about it. Aha! There we go. I have to switch it like that. Good. Just checking, make sure. Good. I'm gonna kick butt now. That's right. As soon as they find out where to go to kick the butt. You can't get over that, okay. We're gonna see more of the wooden soldiers? Or they just hang out over there by the town? All I was doing was... Yeah, I haven't been this far, guys. All I was doing was going back and forth. I fought those two groups of wood soldiers like another 5 times, I think, to get the armor we wanted. So we all have sheet armor. Except for the dog, who can't wear armor at all. And Ada still has the old one. Come back here! I want to level up Ada, you know, at least. The wood soldiers are getting a little bit monotonous to me, though. Wow, 2 hits? And we got rid of one. I want to save these finishing moves. Punch him, McBean. Wow. That was tougher. Well, we got a good hit in with the first one. I don't know. Take him on, bring him on downtown. Yay, Ada. I saw it slowing down. I was like, come on, come on. she didn't learn anything new, though. Can we... It looks like a hidden area with a chest or something, but no, there's nothing here. Let's skip that one. This just goes around this big rock. That one's drunk. He got drunk on too much WD-40. Actually, the wooden soldiers. What? How do you oil a wooden soldier? I don't think you use sap or something. Orb of Ocean 5. Nothing different in particular. Oh, it's under items. An image of Forte shouting. I doubt I'm gonna find all those. That would be crazy. There's a lot of them. Oh, that's a tougher one. These are tougher one, huh? Doesn't like us either. Let's heal up and save and fight the tougher one. I just want to see how tough they would be. Okay, here we go. Aye, aye. It's still curse calling wooden soldiers, but it's a different kind of wooden soldier, isn't it? McBean should be able to reach that one, shouldn't he? Alright, so, as it stands, he should be able to reach that one. The rest of us will wail on wooden soldier B. I don't know how many hits it take for one of these to get taken down. I just want to be able to hit something. And not just move forward and not tick around. Actually, he can keep attacking this one because we're probably going to knock that one out of his range. Okay, not that bad. Let's see his new thing, Loud Rush. Haha, 594 points. Nice. I'm gonna save the others though, since we only got this one guy left. That's a good hit from Forte. Wow. Okay, they weren't too tough. I thought they would be a lot tougher, because that's the... I thought it was the more advanced version of these things. Which way are we supposed to be going? Hidden chest? Oh, it's another way to the same hidden chest. Well, not hidden, but, you know. It's either way. We can't go that way. Can't use your rock crash here, or whatever, Gaia crash. So we're going this way. Is this a way to go? No. Interesting lumpy stuff going on here. I wasn't sure if we were going down or left with that. But it's left, or I guess west. It looks like we like can go like through that, like around it. What's that? Oh. Ground is raised up, it looked like. Can't go that way then. Okay. All right, then what's this way? Impassable. That's what's that way. Whoops. McBain says, wow, I guess things are different near Numeros. There are wood soldiers all over the place. Wood soldier factory, says Ada. Kapuri is probably inside. Woof! Ada, Jan's rooting for you, says Forte. Chi-chi! Says the Rick. And Rick too, says Una. Yeah, thanks. Kapuri is a doll that Grandpa made with all of his heart. He was completed only recently, but I've known him for a long time. He's like the younger brother that I never had. So, no matter what, I want to take him back to Grandpa's place. Sure, that should be no problem, says Forte. We'll do our best for Ada and Kapuri too, says Una, so it'll be okay. And don't forget that I'm here too, says McBain. Don't worry. Forte says, there's a hidden agenda whenever Grandpa's gung-ho about something. What did you say? Ha ha ha, thanks, says Ada. McBain says, we still have some ways to go until we get to Cleda, but we're almost there. Yeah, let's go, says Forte. Let's go, man. Any secret chest up here? Oh, boy. The tuning fork. Let me see if there's any new scenarios. Like, I don't know if there's going to be new scenarios from here on. I haven't encountered anything new. Czar Shrine. Oh, we go through the tuning fork. It gives us all our points and magic points and everything back. That's great. Good to know. I'm going to save here because we're going to try the Czar Shrine. I knew there was one more shrine in A Tear of a Million, right? Four shrines. Just because these tend to be tough, and this was just added, so this might be extraordinarily tough. Right, so we got Scotia Shrine, which is the first, Eden Shrine, Niftish Shrine, and then Czar Shrine. Let's try Czar Shrine. I'm gonna bother with the monsters, unless I can't get past them or something. Oh, there's chests in here. Sono Memory 19. I forget what that is. Sounds heard? Oh, 19. Tiny piece storing music from the past plays My Name is Bardas, Divine Sword. Oh, sweet. Can we leave without fighting the thing? God, these things are all over the place. No. But I want to go in the other shrines and see if there's chests that I missed, actually. Because I didn't realize there would be chests around here. Trying to not to get in an unnecessary battle. I mean, we could. There's no chest on this side. Oh, look at that! With the eyes! I'm not sure I noticed this when I was playing through this in Tear of a Million, how the eyes blink like that. They only blink, but they blink on and then get more intense and turn off. That's pretty sweet. I mean, maybe it didn't do that in that game and they just added that in. I don't know. Who knows? Oops. Oh, Borgied, yeah. Guard Corps B and A. Alright, well, we're gonna attack Borgied and we're gonna interrupt Borgied as often as we can. Which maybe twice, and then maybe by then, what's her name here? We'll have her finishing move as well. Una. No, you don't. It's a new finishing move, too. Whoa. Nice. We'll let the guards attack. Ouch. Okay, he's beat. Knocked the crap out of our dog. What the hell? And the dog was the one with the other finishing move. Who goes first? Forte, I think, out of the three of us. Resurrect powder. Right, revives and completely restores hit points. The rest of us will attack Borgied. Missed. I like that. We can't interrupt Borgied. Flare Ghost. Oh crap. Oh man. Can we? I was wrong about the dog. Alright, who's going now? Forte. He went last. Alright, so I have Forte attack Borgied. Have Una. Resurrect. McBain. And have Jan and Rick heal Forte. And then interrupt with Charge Dog. Oh, we don't get an upgrade for Charge Dog? That's not fair. Oh crap, they hit so hard. Charge Dog. Hit the guard core too, while you're at it. Thank you. Man, they hit really hard. Okay. Two of us are messed up, two of us are fine. Una has another interrupt. Alright, so let's see. Have him attack Borgied. Una. There's a good chance he's not going to make it to cast her spell, but I'm going to try. Life full heal. On self, I guess. Yeah. McBain attacks Borgied. Jan and Rick heal Forte. Now Forte goes first. I can't keep this straight. Interrupt. I had on the wrong person too. Spread arrow. This is her new move. Wow. Nice! Oh, we defeated Borgied and thus defeated the other two. Una saves the day with 8 hit points. Wow. That's a good amount of XP. Yes, I made it, says Forte. McBain says, I see that you had a great training. Let's come back here together, Forte, says Una. Woof woof! Squeak! It was a great fun, says Ada. Let's do this together again. Maybe. But I don't know, I haven't done the repeating. Do you want to go back to the original world? Yes. That was cool. It was fun whipping Borgied's butt again. I'll tell you that much. I couldn't stand that guy. And I'm not about to start standing him now. This goes around the rock. Around the rock. Alright, so we've got... No, we don't. No, we only can go this way. I like the bass. Boom, 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 boom. That's a funky bass in the background now. Jeez, this is a long way. You said... excuse me. You said... McBain said we're almost there, though. I guess it's how you would define almost there. Around the rock again. I'm looking around for chests and stuff, that's why I keep walking all over the place. That's why. Cleda. I like this theme. Grandpa, it's hard to get in because there's a guard. A voice says, hey, it's time. Oh, finally, says the gatekeeper. It's time to change. Oh, so they both change at once? The soldier went away, says Forte. Now's our chance, says McBain. Let's go. But I wanted to look at the sign. The soldier says, stop. Stop right there. Gatekeeper says, you must have some guts. You know the punishment for trying to escape, don't you? No, it's just that we're breaking in. 100 whips. Women, children, it doesn't matter. Please, wait, says another voice. Who's that? Forte says, huh? Oh, it's, what's his name? Captain Palman? I'm sorry about this. I asked these kids to do something for me. You made a request without telling us, says the gatekeeper. Grandpa Mac, this man... says Una. Shh. No, it's not a big deal, he says. Please forgive us. The man gave something to the soldier. Paying him off? Some gents, a little gents, exchanging hands? Fine then, says the gatekeeper. Ahem, if this happens again, you're going to be punished for lack of management. Lack of management? I will be careful. Okay, everyone, come. I'll make sure you go back to the factory. But I want to read this sign and look around the town. How dare you? The director says, where were you? A newbie got lost. Palman says, I'll get back to work immediately. So you put Captain Palman to work in the factory? The director says, hey, you and you. Okay, which you? Yes, sir? Me? Says Forte. Me? Says Ada. You two go collect the work reports from each leader in each room and bring them back to me. The man can go around the first floor. The woman can go around the second floor. Be quick about it. Forte, says Una. Go, says McBean. And don't raise any suspicion. Okay. What's the holdup? You want me to go to the second floor and collect the work reports, right? Says Ada. Okay, I understand. I'm going then. Forte can't move yet. No, I can. You have permission to go to the second floor? Yep, I do. Let me pass. Collect reports and deliver it to the director. You aren't allowed to do anything else. That's awfully limiting. That door's not opening. What? Don't pay attention to anything but work. Hello, peoples. Roraru's father. Oh, we were looking for them. Kinda. I don't want to make something as terrible as this, but I wonder what Barriga would do if I resist. I have a small son in Gezalg. Mina's father. My wife has fallen due to exertion. I wish I can take her home to Gezalg. Ronald's son. I wonder how father's doing. I wonder how lonely everyone at Gezalg are. Yeah, I think that's the one with the father who says he's lonely. The second floor is the research lab, says Gameru. Barriga is making a new type of wood soldier. He's probably planning on attacking other countries with it. He's such a nice man. You came to collect the reports? This is it. Please give this to the director. Forte and his friends were entrusted with parts report. The director's pretty impatient. If you're not quick, he'll yell at you. Hurry and go. Yeah. Can we read this book? Work progress report for the parts room at Cleda's Wood Soldier Factory. Yeah, we can't read it. Can we return them one by one or just get them all? I guess I'll get them all because I don't know where the guy is. Oh. Yeah, he's in here. Did you bring the reports? Hand it over parts report. The ASCII report is missing. The fuel report is missing. Bring it at once. Bring them quickly. Oh, come, let me out. Thank you. Roraru's mother. Something terrible is being made upstairs. They are giving wood soldiers magical powers by incorporating a strange stone inside. Now's a chance, Forte, says McBain. Collect information, pretending to work. Oh, that's McBain. I didn't realize he wasn't part of our crew. Okay, yeah, I thought that looked like Una. Forte, be careful. Don't try too hard. Takuto says, I heard that there's something called a resonance stone in the mirror cave that is to the south of Cleda. The soldiers are looking really hard for it. They're planning on building it into the wood soldiers. They're trying to develop a powerful wood soldier that can use spells. That's not good. No, definitely not good. Oh, there's Palman. They still don't refer to him as Captain Palman. I'll explain later. Just do as I say for now. This man, says Forte, is he... You know it's Captain Palman. No one else has that emo haircut in this game. You're here to collect the reports, right? Good work. Forte and his friends were entrusted with Assy Report. I was like, what's wrong? Go ahead and go to the director. Put these things on the shelf here. Just caught my eye. Well, I can't actually go over there, but... Like, Forte is, like, facing that shelf. They look like fortune cookies. Let's give him this report and leave him without the other report. See what he says. Did you bring the reports? Hand it over Assy Report. The fuel report is missing. Bring it at once. Bring them quickly. Can I talk to this guard? Don't pay attention to anything about work, yeah. So once we talk to him, that's the last report. Let's see what's over here. Ah. He's guarding the stairwell. What a noble duty. I can't allow you to go basement. I cannot allow you to go basement. Nope. No go basement. Siren says, my husband is in the parts room. I get so worried because we're forced to work separately. Kiska's mother. It looks like there's a control device for the power downstairs. If we destroy this, the factory will cease to function. Good to know. Final report. You're collecting the reports? I wonder if I can trust you. Forte and his friends were entrusted with fuel report. The director is in the completed unit storage room. Run! Run, I tell you! Run! I kind of like just... I know it doesn't make a difference. I felt like annoying this guy by giving him run report at a time. Since he wanted it done so quickly, this is a slower way to do it. Hand it over a fuel report. I see. Everything seems okay. Now go upstairs. Hand this to the director of the lab. Forte was entrusted with 1F report. An important experiment is going on upstairs. Don't interrupt them, okay? Now go deliver the reports quickly.